Hello dear students, so today we are going to learn about Ackermann steering gear mechanism. So first we'll start with the construction. Let's draw all the reference lines in yellow for our convenience. As we all know, first we have the front axle. This is the front axle. And then we have the wheels. Let's draw first the reference lines. Two vertical lines I'm drawing for reference purpose over here. And then one more over here. This should be parallel, right? Yes. Okay, let's say that we have wheels. I'll just draw it with red. This is one of the wheels. And then let's say that. This is another wheel. And now we have bell crank levers. In pink, I'm drawing it in pink. So this bell crank levers are behind the front axle. In Davies mechanism, we have seen that the bell crank levers are in front of the front axles. But here, the bell crank levers are behind the front axle. So clearly, I think we can identify that we have bell crank levers, right? And now there is another link. I'm drawing it in green. We call it cross link. And this link is parallel to the front axle, which connects the two bell crank levers. And one more thing is, we have few distances which are equal. Let's clearly mention them. Let's say that this is a revolute joint here. There's a revolute joint here. There's a revolute joint here and here. It's a four bar chain or four bar mechanism where you can see, I can give the numbers like the pink ones are two bell crank levers, so two links. And then the front axle is one of the links. And parallel to front axle, you have cross link, which is connecting two bell crank levers, right? And this is another link. So I'll just give the numbering. For our convenience, we can say that this is one, this is two, this is three and four links. Or it's better to write this like I'll say that this is point A, point B, point C and point D. So AB is one link, BD is another link, CD is another link and AC is another link. And I will mention here, AC is equal to BD, yes, and AB is parallel to CD. So this is the configuration of Ackermann steering gear mechanism. Now, whenever we are going to take a right or a left turn, let me mention that turn, let me draw that turn clearly. So that we won't get any confusion further. So whenever we are going to take a right turn, we see that the bell crank lever looks something like this. So this is the wheel turning, right? So wheel has turned. The entire new configuration is drawn with the blue color. So it has to move over here. So actually it will move in this manner. See, only till this distance it will move this way. But for our convenience, I'm going to draw it on this, project it on this line further. And over here also, you are going to have this wheel in this manner. Yes, the new configuration. And then the bell crank has to move in this direction. All right. And this is the new position of the link. new position of the link. Actually, here also it won't be on the straight line. It will be some inclination, but for convenience, for further calculations, this is the best way that I could write. So now, initially, we have an angle which I didn't mention earlier. Let me mention all the angles with this green ink. So initially, with respect to the vertical yellow reference line, we have alpha. Initially, with yellow, both the sides, we have the angle alpha. Now, while you are turning, we can see that D has come to D dash and C has come to C dash. Now, if you see the changed positions, when the link bell crank lever has come from D to D dash, the inner wheel has turned to, from its initial position, the angle turned is theta, and the outer wheel, outer bell crank lever, or the outer wheels connected with bell crank lever, has turned to an angle phi from the initial position. So let's say this is phi. And we have an assumption over here that D D dash will be equal to C C dash. So based on this assumption, we are going to solve the problem to find out alpha. We have to find out alpha here, where you initially will construct the Ackermann steering gear. You have to find out alpha first. So for that reason, our initial assumption is that distance C dash C is equal to D dash D. And let's say that the length of the bell crank lever over here is L, which is equal over here. It means AB BD is equal to L. And can you say BD dash also is same length? Yes, BD dash also is same length, because link length won't change. Fine, link length will never change. And actually, when it's turning, so this is the place where D dash will be there, but I'm projecting it on AB. Like, it's like AB, I should be projecting on AB, but I'm projecting parallel to AB, which is on the other side. That's why I put D dash here. Okay, so you can see that the length is same, B D dash. Just for convenience, we projected over here. And here also, if you check, the same thing happens. Okay, AC is equal to AC dash. So I'll just write down over here, even those things, to remove all the confusions, is equal to AC dash. AC is equal to H. And this is L, okay. So now we are going to find out what is CC dash. CC dash is this distance from here to here. And we have this as L, and here we can see that this is 90 degrees, right, on both the sides. So I can see two right angle triangles in ACC dash, right? In ACC dash, so here we'll draw it clearly. So we have A and C, C dash, and there is a right angle triangle over here, and this is also L, and this is also L. Now CC dash, can we calculate what is CC dash? CC dash is equal to, and we even have, see, this angle over here is, I'll just mention it outside. So it is total angle is phi minus alpha, right? So this angle is phi minus alpha. And let me light it clearly. Sorry. So I'll write down here that angle is phi minus alpha. And what is this angle? This angle is alpha, right? So now we can add, just put a point O here. I can say that C dash O plus OC is your CC dash, which is equal to C dash O is L sine phi minus alpha. How is it? You can say sine theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse, right? So I'll write down here. Okay, after we write down this OC also, I'll be writing it L sine alpha. Okay, OC is L sine alpha. Since sine theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. So opposite side, I think you can clearly see OC is the, O dash C is the opposite side, hypotenuse is L, right? So sin phi minus alpha is, just cross multiply it, you'll get the answer. Okay, so now this CC dash distance is known. We wish to find out now DD dash distance also. Now to find out DD dash distance, I'm going to just do it over here. Just to draw that triangle, whatever you can see. Done. So I can see 90 degrees somewhere over here. Yes, this is 90 degrees. And this is D. This is D dash. And let's say this is again O. Okay, in this triangle, this is again O, no problem, right? Yes. And this is L over here. You can see that length. This is also L and this is also L. So they are having very small displacement theta. So for that, you can almost say that they both are equal. Okay. Not an issue. Then we have angles also. So this is alpha independently and this is theta. So theta is here and I'll mention alpha is here. Now what to do if I want to find out D, D dash. So to find out D, D dash, I can write it this way, right? O, D dash minus O, D or D, O. Yes, can I write that? O, D dash minus D, O. So what is O, D dash? Because we have a right angle triangle this way. That's why I have written the total. O, D dash is L sine theta plus alpha, right? You can check it from the triangle. And minus D, O is L sine alpha. Now I got D, D dash, I got C, C dash. Now my job is to equate them because that is the first assumption which we have done. I have assumed. Assumed, okay, because there will be a small, very, very, very small error, okay. So now you equate them both. If you equate them both, we are going to get in this manner. See, L sine phi plus phi minus alpha. Sine A minus B is sine A cos B minus cos A sine B, right? And then plus L sine alpha, which is equal to, let's call it equation 1. This is equation 2. Equate 1 and 2. So 1 equal to 2. So I'll write down here, equate 1 and 2. Okay. Which is equal to, let's wait, yes. Which is equal to, now come to RHS, take L common, sine A plus B is sine A cos B plus cos A sine B and minus L sine alpha. I think you can see a very, very common thing, which is L on LHS and RHS. Just cancel it out. Now, we'll take all the sine terms to one side and cos terms to another side. So, I'll take sine terms. So, I can say sine alpha, take common over here. So, sine alpha is taken common. So, you can say it is 2 sine alpha. This sine alpha will come to this side. So, it becomes 2 sine alpha. Right? So, hold on guys. Sine alpha is taken common. So, only 2 comes on the other side. Now, I can write down this as minus cos phi. And then is there any sine alpha here? Yes, minus cos theta. So sine alpha is taken on LHS and on RHS, I'm going to take cos alpha common. So if you take cos alpha common here, sine theta will come out, get inside, sorry. And then is there a cos alpha on this side? Yes, minus sine phi, because this sine phi will come to the other side. Yes, now we are done. Now, cross multiply cos alpha to the denominator, then it becomes tan alpha. It becomes tan alpha is equal to sine theta minus sine phi divided by 2 times cos phi minus cos theta. To make it look a little better, what we do is we'll just write down, we'll write tan alpha is equal to multiply and divide with minus sign. So it will be like a sine phi minus sine theta divided by cos theta plus cos phi minus 2. So finally, we are going to get this equation. From here, you can find out what alpha is. Alpha is tan inverse sine phi minus sine theta divided by cos theta plus cos phi minus 2. Now here, what is phi? What is phi and what is theta? I'll just mention it here clearly. You can see that so theta is angle turned by angle turned by inner wheel, and phi is angle turned by outer wheel. So phi is angle turned by outer wheel. Now, how to find out this theta and phi? So theta and phi can be found out from the correct equation of steering. We have the correct equation of steering derived in the previous videos, right? Which is cot phi minus cot theta is equal to W by L, where W is the track width, which is the distance between this A and B, sorry, distance between the wheels, and L is the wheel base. So track width and wheel base. By knowing one of any one of the angles, like for suppose you know the angle theta, you are going to know the angle phi. Done? So this is the way we are going to find out theta and phi, and that we can substitute in this equation, which we found in the end, which is tan alpha is equal to sine phi minus sine theta by cos theta plus cos phi minus 2. Substitute in this, you will get alpha to construct this Ackermann steering gear mechanism. And very, very important point to be noted is Ackermann steering gear mechanism, you will have correct steering only in 3 positions. So correct steering only possible in 3 positions. The first position is when the vehicle is moving in the straight path. When the vehicle is moving in the straight path. So straight path. And number 2, when the vehicle is taking the extreme left. Extreme left. And number 3, when the vehicle is taking extreme right. It means left turn, right turn, and straight path. In between this straight path, for example, see, this is the wheel, right? And you have your bell crank lever in this manner. So in this path, okay, done. It is going to produce a proper steering. And the next path will be like something like this, like extreme while it's moving to the, it's taking the left turn. See, this is going, sorry, right turn. So in this configuration also, it will do good. And the angle here will be angle turned by the inner wheel, this will be the inner wheel, so the angle turned will be theta, right? And then while it's going to the extreme right also, left also, it will follow the proper path. So let us take some other color. So extreme right means you'll have the wheel in this manner, right? So wheel will be something like this while it's going to the extreme right, and your bell crank lever will be something like this. So here the angle turned will be phi, because it is the outer wheel now. Left turn, this is the outer wheel. For right turn, this will be the inner wheel, the same position, okay? And then you will have the straight path. So for these three positions, only the correct steering is possible. In remaining positions, in between these positions, between means from this mean position to this position, while it is traveling, anywhere in between, here, 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 anywhere in between, here, here, here. So anywhere in between, it is going to not have pure rotation, but some slipping will take place. So some skidding will take place. So that's why while you are taking a turn, the rider is going to slow down, because if you are going to go in a very fast manner and it is going to skid, so there is a high probability that the tires are going to wear out very soon. It will be weared out very soon because there is a skidding motion. So if you are rubbing something against a friction surface, it is going to wear out very soon, right? So that skidding will take place. So that's why whenever we are taking a right turn or a left turn, we are going to slow down the vehicle so that to avoid the skidding and to avoid the wear of the tires. So this is Ackermann steering gear mechanism. Thank you.